Thank you.
So you're gonna see that, and it's gonna be great. Well, let's get going here, and if people join, we'll just let them hopefully catch up. But we're gonna start with Hungry Heart. Now, just as a guess, how many number one hits do you think Bruce Springsteen in his vast career had?
Hmm.
Yeah.
10? 3?
Zero.
Oh, zero.
Zero. None. He never had a number one hit. He still has never had a number one hit. So in spite of that, you know, he's had a pretty good career. But this was his second biggest hit. His number one hit was Dancing in the Dark, which went to number two in 1984. This one is 1980, and it was his first big hit, and it only went to number five. But Bruce Springsteen, it's kind of like when we had our discussions about Neil Diamond, and he only had two number one hits, Cracklin' Rosie and Song Sung Blue. And it's like, you've got to be kidding. Here's a guy who's just wrote all kinds of number one hits for everybody else, but he actually didn't have many for himself. But Springsteen, this was his first big hit, and that came in 1980. And I would have thought that Born to Run would have been part of it, would have been a number one hit, but it only went to number 53 of all things. So his legend is grown as a result of, other things, not driving the songs to the top of the chart, but legendary concerts. A friend of mine, she's from New Jersey, and so she's been to about a dozen of his concerts, and they go on for hours and hours and hours. Well, he's 4-hour concert is not unusual for him. Anyway, let's start this one. This is the top line on the intro. Notice that on that E flat minor 7, that is the second position. So that is. That's that second fret. So the intro, basically the whole song is. Can you guys hear my ukulele? Okay. So it's. So it's basically that through the whole song. Now, when you get down to the chorus, the first time through the chorus, we hit that D flat, and then we just keep playing that same chord pattern right through. The second time, you hit an E, and that then goes to the instrumental section. So that's the only kind of weird thing on the charting that might confuse you. But the chart looking at the instrumental section, which is on the top of page 2, that is that D flat minor is the fourth fret. So you go E to the fourth fret, but it's an easy change because when you've put your E, you'll notice your E is right there. And then you just shift up because your fingers are already there. So it makes it easy to hit that 4. And then the G flat minor 7 is the second fret. Okay. And then it resolves with A flat. Okay, here we go. Got a wife and kids in Baltimore, Jack. I went out for a ride and I never came back. Like a river that don't know where it's flowing, took a wrong turn and I just kept going. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Let's start that chorus again. I just totally screwed up. I don't know what I did. I've been playing the song all day. Here we go. Let's try it again. Got a wife and kids in Baltimore, Jack. I went out for a ride and I never went back. Like a river that don't know where it's flowing. Took a wrong turn and I just kept going. Oh, everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. I met her in a Kingston bar. We fell in love, I knew it had to end. We took what we had and we ripped it apart. Now here I am down in Kingston again. Oh, everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody needs a place to rest. Everybody wants to have a home. Don't make no difference what nobody says. Ain't nobody like to be alone. Oh, everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. I know it says repeat three times, but since we're going to do it again, we'll just do it again. Everybody have any trouble with those chords? Okay, let's give her another run. Ready? One and two and... Got a wife and kids in Baltimore, Jack. I went up for a ride and I never went back. Like a river that don't know where it's flowing. I took a wrong turn and I just kept going. Oh, everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Met her in a Kingstown bar. We fell in love, I knew it had to end. We took what we had and we ripped it apart. Now here I am down in Kingstown again. Oh, everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a happy heart. Everybody needs a place to rest. Everybody wants to have a home. Don't make no difference what nobody says. Ain't nobody like to be alone. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Everybody's got a hungry heart. Lay down your money and you play your part. Everybody's got a hungry heart. There we go. Off and running. Let's go to Ramblin' Rose. This is a Nat King Cole song. And Nat was, of course, he was a fabulous, really fabulous jazz singer and pianist. And but then he moved over into the pop side, and this was one of his biggest hits. He went to number two on the pop charts, which is kind of odd, but it was blocked from being in the number one slot because of the song by the Four Seasons, Sherry. But it was number one on the easy listening chart. But it's quite a nice song. Here we go. Ramblin' Rose, Ramblin' Rose, why you ramble, no one knows. Wild and wind blown, that's how you've grown. Can cling to a rambling road. Ramble on, ramble on. When you're rambling, days are gone. Song, very, very, you know, middle of the road kind of stuff for a guy who was, again, really a classic jazz player and singer. But of course, he had so many great hits in the late 50s and early 60s. But let's do this again. Here we go. Ramblin' Rose, Ramblin' Rose. Why you ramble, no one knows. Wild and wind blown,
That's how you've grown. Who can cling to a rambling road? Ramble on, ramble on. When you're rambling, days are gone. Who will love you with a love true when you're rambling? Days are gone. Rambling Rose, Rambling Rose, why I want to, heaven knows. Though I love you with a love true, who can cling to a rambling rose? Rambling rose, rambling rose, why I want you, heaven knows. Though I love you with a love true, who can cling to a rambling rose?
Pretty little song. Okay, let's move on to our Halloween novelty. You got a question, Irene?
Yeah. Hey, Dave.
Yes.
When you do that C minor, me, whatever that was.
Yes, C minor.
What finger are you barring with, and what finger reaches the top string?
Your ring finger will reach the top string, and you bar with your index finger. So you can see.
No. Okay.
Your ring finger doesn't reach? Try your pinky then. You should be able to get it. I know the ring finger should get there. You can do it with your middle finger, but it's you got a better chance of messing it up.
It's two frets away though. It's not working. I was just curious. Thank you.
Well, when you get into something like that, then you start looking around and you say, well, what other positions are C minor? And you'll find maybe different shape. Yeah. When you go to the second position, C minor, it will have a different shape and it will be more like D minor. So D minor is like, you know what D minor is. Okay. Move it up one fret. That's D sharp minor. Move it up one fret. That's also C minor. So if you do your D minor like this, then you'll have to move it over, and then you'll do your D minor like that with your middle finger on the E string, and then your ring finger all the way over, and then you can do that. That's a different way of doing the same chord.
Okay, thank you.
I'll just
smile during that one.
Well, you can always just, nice thing about it, just sing it. But unfortunately, we got C minor coming up here in the next song.
That's okay.
But
good for me.
Yeah, you just gotta reach over. Now, what happens with a lot of people when I see them playing, they hold their ukulele like this. Don't. Move your hand. When I played violin when I was a kid, they teach you to kick your elbow way over, and that's way you can get your better. So if you move your thumb to the bottom third of your, like here, you'll kick your hand out and it will move you over. That could be what you're running into. So bring your hand out and you'll hit them.
Thank you.
That may help. Okay. So this Ghost Chickens in the Sky, a lot of people have done this. And of course, it's a parody of Ghost Riders in the Sky. But we're doing this for our Halloween. I did the Barry Ward version. So if you go on YouTube, you can do the Barry Ward version. And that's because he added the original, he had the first couple of lines here. So it sets up the song. Most of the other people at versions, you'll see cut off that part of it. So I added that in. But that's why when you see up on the top of these, that when I'm charting them, when I see Barry Ward up there or whoever, that's the version that I charted. And so when you're looking it up in YouTube or whatever, that's who to look for. Okay, here we go. Here's our C again, C minor. But again, kick that hand out a little bit. An old cowboy went out and bought a ranch in 65. Spent all of his money and no cattle could he buy. So he called up Colonel Sanders and said, "What should I do?" The colonel said, "Buy chickens and build a chicken coop." Now he's been a chicken rancher since he was 24. Yeah, working for the colonel for 30 years or more. Fixing up those chickens and sending them to fry. Now they want revenge. Ghost chickens in the sky. Chickens to bake. Chickens to fry. Ghost chickens in the sky. He was out a-walking on his chicken ranch one day. He stopped along the chicken coop as he went along his way. And all at once a rotten egg it hit him in the eye. It was a terrible sight. Ghost chickens in the sky. Their beaks are black and shiny and their eyes are fiery red. These chickens ain't got no feathers, folks. These chickens are all dead. And they pecked on that rancher and he died by the claw. They fixed him extra crispy. And they served him with coleslaw. Chickie-eye, chickie-eye-o. Ghost chickens in the sky. Now let this song remind you, if you want eternal peace, don't raise up harmless poultry for to cook them in the grease. For if you raise animals, you someday will kill. A chicken may come back to haunt you, but tofu never will. Chickie-eye, chickie-eye-o. In the sky. Silly song, but fun. If you got grandkids or kids in your neighborhood, they'll like it. Let's just go ahead and move on from that one. I don't think we need to do that twice.
That is my kind of love song, though.
That is, I had a feeling that that would fit. You know, it's just wait till you get to the, we're going to get you to the one. I said to everybody today when we were playing it, I says, I got this. I did this just for Irene, our friend Irene. She's going to love this. And they all laughed. They know you. They know you. Anyway, this is a great, great Happy Holly song. This is our Happy Holly song of the day. And this was written by a guy named R. Alex Anderson, who is a lifelong resident of Oahu. And so he wrote a lot of the great, great Happy Holly classics, including Lovely Hula Hands and Meli Kalikimaka. So when you're singing Meli Kalikimaka, it's R. Alex Anderson song. And now this one was done, the chart of the song was done by Louis Armstrong. And, you know, he actually, you know, during the 20s and 30s, the Hawaiian music was pretty prevalent. And so even him, as great a trumpeter and great a jazz guy, he actually, you know, was recording some of this stuff too. So it's kind of nice. I think it's pretty fair, pretty easy. On the end of the first page, bottom line, you'll see a double sign. That's where we're going to end the song, is there. So when we go through the bridge, we'll repeat the last on the second page, the last verse line over there. Then we'll do an instrumental version and then repeat from the bridge. But we end at that double. End at that double line right there. So here we go. On a coconut island, I'd like to be a castaway with you. On a coconut island, there wouldn't be so very much to do. I would linger a while and just gaze into your lovely eyes of blue. Then I'd walk for a mile and come running back to be with you. There the waves would make a pair of willing slaves of you and me forever. And for days and days and days would never gaze at where the ships go sailing by. On a coconut island, I'd like to be a castaway with you. On a coconut island, we couldn't make our dreams come true. On a coconut island, I'd like to be a castaway with you. On a coconut island, there wouldn't be so very much to do. I would linger a while and just gaze into your lovely eyes of blue. Then I'd walk for a mile and come running back to be with you. Repeat the bridge. There the waves would make a pair of willing slaves of you and me forever. And for days and days and days would never gaze at where the ships go sailing by. On a coconut island, I'd like to be a castaway with you. Just to bask in your smile and to realize my dreams come true. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. Back at the bridge. There the waves would make a willing pair of slaves for you and me forever. And for days and days would never gaze on where the ships go sailing by. On a coconut island, I'd like to be a castaway with you. On a coconut island, where we could make our dreams come true. Cute little song. Cute little song. Want to do that one again? Nobody jumping up and down saying they want to do it again. It's an easy song, so I mean, you guys shouldn't have any problem with it. So let's move on to something a little more difficult. Not really. This one's easy too. This is only 16 by Dr. Hook in a Medicine Show. Now, this was actually written by Sam Cooke in 1959, and he released it and went to number 15 on the R&B charts. But, you know, not that big a hit. A big hit, but not that big a hit. But Dr. Hook had the biggest hit with it in 1975, and he took it to number 6 on the overall chart. But the interesting thing about this song was is it was, for some reason, banned by the BBC. I don't, for the life of me, playing through it, I don't understand why. I mean, there's nothing really suggestive. It's just teenagers in love and nothing gets requited. He comes to the conclusion that she's not buying whatever he's selling. And it's just, you know, it's too late or too early for both of them. Why the BBC would ban it, I don't know. I mean, they got a lot more lurid, like the, you know, I could understand Louie Louie last month. Yeah, okay. Only because you couldn't understand a thing that Kingsmen were singing, but this one I don't understand. But be that as it may, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's do it again. She was only 16. Only 16, but I loved her so. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. We'd laugh and we'd sing and do funny things, and it made our hearts glow. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. So why did I give my heart so fast? Never will happen again. But I was a mere child of 16. I've aged a year since then. She was only 16, only 16. But she had eyes would glow. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. Da 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 da. So why did I give my heart so fast? It never will happen again. But I was a mere child of 16. I've aged a year since then. She was only 16, only 16. Oh, but I loved that girl so. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. Yeah, she was too young to fall in love, and I was too young. I was much too young to know. Pretty little song, but again, can you imagine why would BBC have a problem with that? Unless the program director had a 16-year-old daughter and he just didn't want to hear about it at all. And that's the only thing that makes any sense to me, that why they would ban it. Because, I mean, it's just a cute little love song, but, you know, unrequited love and, you know, everything is good. So let's do it again. Ready? She was only 16, only 16. But I loved her so. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. We'd laugh and we'd sing and do funny things, and it made our hearts glow. She was She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. So why did I give my heart so fast? It never will happen again. But I was a mere child of 16. I've aged a year since then. She was only 16, only 16. But she had eyes that would glow. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. So why did I give my heart so fast? It never will happen again. But I was a mere child of 16, an age of years since then. She was only 16, only 16. Oh, but I loved that girl so. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young to know. She was too young to fall in love, and I was too young. I was much too young to know. Pretty little song. We haven't done enough. I haven't charted enough Sam Cooke songs. So that's a nice way of getting into it. All right, let's move on to one I'm sure that Irene would enjoy. It's Taking Care of Business. So this was written by Randy Bachman, and this is Bachman Turner Overdrive. And Randy Bachman with Burton Cummins was the core of the Canadian group Guess Who. And so, hi Phil, how you doing? So Guess Who didn't turn down. He wrote the song and took it to Burton Cummins. Burton Cummins took one look at it, listened to it, and says, "Oh no, we're not doing that. That's the chords and everything's a paperback writer, and we're just gonna get our butt sued. We're not doing that song." So he put it back in his pocket. And when he broke up with the Guess Who and started Bachman Turner Overdrive, brought it back out. And I don't know if he ever got sued or not, but it is their signature song. I think it was the biggest song that they ever had. Went to number 6 on Cashbox and number 12 on the top 100. So it's a pretty good hit, but it's pretty much, you know, when you think of Bachman Turner Overdrive, this is the one. Now we've got a couple of really lengthy on the second page. When you go into the instrumental, they jam. You're just sitting there with that C times 16. We're not going to do that. I'm charting these again to the exact what's happening on the record. So they're jamming away at that. But, you know, when you're just sitting there playing 16 count one, it's painful. So we're going to hit it a little bit, and then we're going to go right back into the instrumental, the normal instrumental, which is basically this is a four chord repeating song. Just goes over and over and around and around. Okay, so... we'll make a couple of modifications on that. And the same thing with the instrumental and the outro, where they got 16 bars of C before they start taking care of business, which is fine if we had a lead guitar, but since we're all alone here, we're just going to cut that down and just play it through. But if you choose to play along with the video of it on YouTube or Spotify or wherever you listen to your music, that's why that's there, so that you can play along with it. No, you're not supposed to be moving on yet. You're just sitting there, you know, waiting and waiting and waiting for the lead guitarist to get done with his instrumental. Okay, so here we go. Nothing else, I think. Pretty straightforward, but...
You get up every morning for your alarm clock's warning. Take the 8:15 into the city. There's a whistle up above and people pushing, people shoving, and the girls who try to look pretty. And if your train's on time, you can get to work by 9 and start your slaving job to get your pay. If you ever get annoyed, look at me, I'm self-employed. I love to work at nothing all day. And I'll be taking care of business every day, taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business, it's all mine, taking care of business and working overtime. Work out! For as easy as fishing, you could be a musician if you could make sounds loud or mellow. Get a second-hand guitar, chances are you'll go far if you get in with the right bunch of fellows. People see me having fun, just a lying in the sun. Tell them that you like it this way. It's the work that we avoid, and we're all self-employed. We love to work at nothing all day. And I'll be taking care of business every day, taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business, it's all mine, taking care of business and working overtime. This is that 16 count. Okay, let's play it again, the instrumental again, right? Take good care of my business when I'm away every day. Woo! Now we go back to the first verse. You get up every morning from your alarm clock's warning. Take the 8:15 into the city. There's a whistle up above, people pushing, people shoving, and the girls who try to look pretty. And if your train's on time, you can get to work by 9 and start your slaving job to get your pay. If you ever get annoyed, look at me, I'm self-employed. I love to work at nothing all day. And I'll be taking care of business every day, taking care of business every way. I've been taking care of business, it's all mine, taking care of business and working overtime. Now we're at the outro where you got that 16 again. We're not going to do all of them. Now here we go, ready? Here of business, taking care of business, taking care of business, taking care of business, taking care of business every day, taking care of business every way, taking care of business, it's all mine, taking care of business, working overtime, taking care of business, taking care of business, taking care of business, taking care of business. One more. Taking care of business, taking care of business.
There we go. Pretty easy song, simple, you know, but again, Guess Who probably could have been a big hit for them, but obviously a big hit for Bachman Turner Overdrive. I just lost a nuke here. So anybody want to do that one again, or you got that one? That one's pretty easy and you can handle that one. Don't want to do it again. I thought, Irene, I thought this was your right up your alley. I thought this one was going to be a bang, 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 bang. Okay. Let's go on to Sister Golden here. And this was written by the group America, which is a misnomer because I don't see Roger on the line, but Roger from the UK. This is America, that they were two British guys. So they came over and made all this money and, you know, romanced our women on this side of the Atlantic and had big hits and everything. And they were not Americans at all. They were English. So, but that be that as it may, this was their second biggest hit, second number one in a row. Their first one was Horse with No Name. And it, to me, it sort of drones. So I didn't chart that one and I picked this one instead. And it went to number one as well. So it's a number one song for the great group America. Now looking at the intro, that is C sharp minor. So we've been playing the C minor on the third fret, but this one is actually one fret up. That little tiny dot over there to the left is the C sharp is the fourth fret. So Irene, you still got the same issue. You're going to have to do that. Now we're going to start working in this week. We're working hard on the G sharp minor. Now you can either finger at that pattern, which I find quite difficult, or you can do your normal G sharp or G minor, and then just use your index finger on your E string. Okay. So basically, the G string. So you do it like that. Okay, so we're going to be playing quite a few of those. We're working on that one. Now, the cheat is use your normal G minor and then just move it up one fret and don't hit your G string. So however you normally finger, otherwise you have to use these three fingers to finger that G, the G minor pattern. But that's how I do it. But you can use that chord, the chord pattern that you got there if you find that easier. You can also bar it and then just drop it in. I find it more difficult to bar it than it is to do it that way. But anyway, so that chord is you're going to see that chord quite a bit today. So that's our chord that everybody's going to hate me for. Anyway, and we got a lot of that coming up in a minute. We got a couple of songs today. You guys are going to, you know, if you check out, I don't blame you, but I am going to always be sad if you do. So stay around. Anyway, here we go. We got one more interesting chord there. Remember a couple of months ago, we were working hard on our suspended chords, and that B suspended. So your normal B is like that. All you have to do is bring your pinky in, drop your pinky on that on your C string like that, or you can try to hit it that way with using your ring finger and your pinky finger, but I find it easy just to hit a B, normal B, only drop that pinky finger in. That's the suspended, you can hear it. That's the resolve chord. So here's your chord that you're resolving. Resolve to B. So just drop your pinky finger in there. Okay, got it? Okay, let's play this song. Has a couple of interesting, you know, it kind of floats around a little bit from if you're listening to it or play it against the take this music later on and play it against the record. It has it changes tempo a little bit here and there, picks up a little speed. But anyway, here we go. Do do. Do, 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 do. Well, I tried to make it Sunday, but I got so damn depressed that I set my sights on Monday and I got myself undressed. I ain't ready for the altar, but I do agree there's times when a woman sure can be a friend of mine. Well,
'Cause I keep on thinking about you, sister, golden hair surprise, and I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent, and I've been too hard to find. Doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the air? Will you love me just a little, just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it, I don't mind saying, just can't make it. I keep on thinking about you, sister, golden hair surprise, and I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent, and I've been too hard to find. But it doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me there? You love me just a little, just enough to show you care. Well, I tried to fake it, I don't mind saying, I just can't make it. Wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo. Wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo. Doo wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo. Doo wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo, wop shoo wop doo.
Well, there's Roger. Hello, Roger. I was just making some disgusting statements. I apologize to all English people that the group America was in fact from the UK. So they came over here and under the stealth of night named themselves America, and we bought everything that they sold. We've got many, many, many big hits from the group America, but it was under subterfuge. I just found that out a couple of days ago, and I was shocked, just shocked. You know, they're writing about Ventura Highway and horses with no names and things like that, and, you know, boom. Turns out there were English couple, couple of guys. So I know this is a kind of a tough song, but, you know, I keep pushing your envelopes for a reason. And, you know, you get better by stretching. And that's what we're trying to do here a little bit. But a lot of the song you should be able to play pretty easily. That G sharp minor, again, we're going to be playing more of it. So I want you to start working that into the repertoire. Try and figure out which way you want to do that. But it's a pretty chord. All right, let's do this one again. One, two, three, four. Do do do. I tried to make it Sunday, but I got so damn depressed that I set my nights on Monday. I got myself undressed. I ain't ready for the altar, but I do agree there's times when a woman sure couldn't be a friend of mine. Well, I keep on thinking about you, sister, golden hair surprise, and I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent, and I've been too hard to find. But it doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will
Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the air? Will you love me just a little, just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it, I don't mind saying I just can't make it. Do 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 do. Well, I keep on thinking about you, Sister Golden Hair Surprise, and I just can't live without you. Can't you see it in my eyes? I've been one poor correspondent, and I've been too hard to find, but it doesn't mean you ain't been on my mind. Will you meet me in the middle? Will you meet me in the air? Will you love me just a little, just enough to show you care? Well, I tried to fake it, I don't mind saying I just can't make it. Doop doop doo 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 wop doop doo doo wop doop 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 doo. Do up, do up, do up, do up, do up, do up, do.
That's a nice song. All right, let's move on to what are we got here? Love is here to stay. This is our adult section of the program. You probably aren't going to like this one very much because it's work. Let me put this one down and get my other one. There we go. Okay. This was written by the Gershwin brothers, George and Ira Gershwin, and it is the last song that George Gershwin wrote before he passed away. And it was written in 1938. It's turned into a class. It's an absolute classic, part of the Great American Songbook. And it's also been used in many, many movies. It was originally written for a movie called The Goldwyn Follies, Samuel Goldwyn Mayer, and you know, so that the part of the studios, but it was the Goldwyn Follies, so it was written originally for that. However, when they did American in Paris, they incorporated it into the soundtrack for that movie. Woody Allen also added it to the soundtrack for Manhattan in 1979, and it was also in the soundtrack for When Harry Met Sally. And about everybody from everybody has done this song. Because, as I say, it's a Great American Songbook standard. So all your torch song guys and, you know, the Frank Sinatras and Tony Bennett's, everybody's done this. I charted the Ella Fitzgerald because I think the purity of her voice is spectacular. And she's not really as recognized as I think she should be. But we have some tough chords here. Now, hopefully you got the new version that I posted in the packet of all the songs together. And I added in, as you note, I added in the strum numbers for both the intro as well as the instrumental. I realized I was derelict in not doing that the first time around. So I went back and added them all in. And this way you can play along again with Ella Fitzgerald's version. Now, we have a couple of tough chords here. They're not tough. They're the second position G7. So your first position G7, as we know, is down here. Second position G7 is at the third fret. And it's the same shape as that F7. You notice that's the same thing? And again, these are movable shapes. You can move this shape all the way up. So if it's in the first fret, it's an F7. What would be the second fret? F sharp. What would be the third fret? G. What would be the fourth fret? G sharp. What would be the fifth fret? A. So here I'm up here in the same. So take that F7 and walk it up with me. F7, F sharp, G7 is right there. That's where I want you to be on this particular song. Then we move up G sharp. By the time you hit the fifth fret with your index finger, that's an A. And that's your normal A that you usually play down there. Okay? So these are movable shape patterns. And that's what I was trying to say to your Irene, when if you can't hit that C minor in that position, well, then take a look at your chord charts and stuff like that that you've got available online and other places. And then look and say, well, where else can I find, what else, where's a C sharp on this fingerboard? There's four of them. There's four C minors. There's four C minors on this fingerboard. You just need to find which one would be easiest for you to play. If you're having a struggle on reaching over, but again, kick your wrist over and you should be able to get that. Okay, so we're going to go on this. You also have the B flat major 7. Well, that's just like B flat, only you just move down. Or just across. And you'll see the B flat major 7 and the B diminished. You just move over. Okay, what else we have here? We have the C7 on the line 3. That's a third fret. That thing is a 3. And that's a second position C7. Remember what we had with the same thing with the F7? Yeah, A7 is right here, right? What would be B7 or B-flat 7? B7, third one, oh, C7. That's how you figure some of this kind of stuff out. It takes a while, but it just, you know, start thinking about what's the pattern, and then just be able to play with it, moving it up the fingerboard. You paid for all of these frets. You might as well use some of them. That's my motto. I'm just saying, you know, why waste a good fingerboard when you got plenty of things you can do up there? The A flat 7 is a little difficult. That's on the 1-2-4th line toward the end, but it's a G7. So if you can hit the G7, you can hit that one by just barring it. Or you can cheat by just doing it. Don't hit the G string and then just move it down. So play the same thing in your normal fingering and just move it down. Just don't hit the G. Just don't hit your G, low or high G, and you're good. On the last line on the first page, you'll see that's a D flat minor. That's a fourth fret. That little tiny dot there, that's a fourth fret, which is the same as what we've been playing with. D flat and C sharp, same thing. So we've been playing. We just got done with arrow. Just got done doing that chord in the last song, but there we were calling it a C sharp. This is part of the confusion and mysteries of music that drive many of us nuts. Not Ryan, because he's smarter than hell, but many of us are, well, why is that a D flat and it's sometimes a C sharp? And it all has to do with ascending and descending and what key you're in. But that's way too much for us today. Here we go. Let's play this. Let me play this song for you. It's a gorgeous song. Dun, 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 dun.
Our love is here to stay.
my love is here to stay. It's here to stay. It's here to stay.
Pretty song. Pretty song. Now, that was actually a little fast. If you play the play this song along with Ella, it's actually slower than that. So when we do it again, was anybody able to play along with that? Or is it this is too much of a challenge? But this is, you know, this is a very jazzy arrangement, and it's very cool to play it. And it's one of those songs that's worth learning. And again, play it slow. And what's we're going to do as soon as my hands quit cramping for a second here. Let's do this again. We'll do it slowly. Ready? One, two, three. It's very clear, our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but forever and a day. The radio and the telephone and the movies that we know may just be passing fancies, and in time may go. But oh my dear, our love is here to stay. Together we're going a long, long way. In time, the Rockies may crumble, Gibraltar may fumble, they're only made of clay, but our love is here to stay. Dum bum bum bum. Have fun with that. Just play around with it. It's a beautiful song, and you can play it slower and slow. Play it slow, and it's still a powerful, powerful song. It's a great song. Okay, we're going to move on to Fanny Be Tender. Now, I told the group this morning that after I went ahead and charted this and thought it would be a great song, I started to do a little research on it, and damn if I didn't find out that the Brothers Gibb, who wrote this, well, they never performed it live because they thought it was too hard. So, yeah, of course, we're already committed. We got no guts, no glory attitude. That's us laugh. And so we're going ahead and do it anyway. We're going to perform it. Now, this was done in 1976, and Quincy Jones was the producer on this. And he thinks it's an R&B song. I don't hear it as an R&B song. I'm not sure. It's just a pretty song. And that originally was just Be Tender With My Love. And they were in Miami recording this thing with Quincy. And they decided that there was a maid at the hotel that they were working that they all got enamored with. And her name was Fanny. And so they decided, instead of just Be Tender With My Love, let's do Fanny as the edits. That's how that came about. But they never performed this live because lots of lush orchestration in this song. And all three of them were singing falsetto. Now, I struggled with this today. It was rather embarrassing. And now that we're on video, I'm not sure, I'm going to struggle through this. But remember, I'm doing this for your benefit so that you can play along with these songs at your leisure. If you really like a song, you can keep playing it and practicing it and getting it down by going to YouTube or whatever and listening to it. Now, we have an E major 7 chord, which is an unusual fingering. But it's a beautiful chord. Now, I gave you an alternative fingering, which is on the 4th fret. But you got to get back down to hit that B7, which is going to be kind of hard. So I would recommend try to learn the first position. That's the first position. The 4th fret, that's your second position, E major 7. But it basically just kind of bounces back between those two chords. So it goes. Now the good part of having that E major 7 is if you're fingering it like that, you don't have to move your ring finger. You just slide your ring finger up and bar. And then you hit that B7 suspended. So you see how that doesn't, you can move. So you just you're sliding your ring finger up and down the fretboard by moving it one fret back and forth. So it makes it easier to kind of locate that chord, that suspended B7 suspended chord. Okay, other than that, I think it's pretty straightforward. And of course, we have a key change just to make matters worse. And there's an A add 9 at the end of the chorus. And all you do on that one is you just bring your ring finger in. If you finger your A with your index and your middle finger, just bring your. It's a pretty chord too. And that also ends up at the end of the song. Okay, let me try to sing this thing. And just remember, they got paid a lot more than I'm getting paid, and they didn't want to do it. But I'm doing it for you, the sacrifices I make.
First I rise, then I fall. Seems like you don't want the love of this man at all. It's sure been a lonely time, right up to the time I met you. So if you take a love like mine, be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to hurt me. Fanny, be tender with my love, 'cause it's all that I got, and my love won't desert me. So you say to yourself, boy, you're out of your brain. Do you think I'm gonna stand here all night in the rain? And it's the start of a love affair. The moment when I first met you, and if you want, I'll take you there. Be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to break me. Fanny, be tender with my love. Because it's all that I got, and my love won't forsake me. With my love, our love will seal it together. With our love, you made a promise you'll always love me forever. Be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to break me. Fanny, be tender with my love. 'Cause it's all I got, and my love won't forsake me. Be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to break me. Fanny, be tender with my love. 'Cause it's all that I got, and my love won't forsake me. Be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to break me. Fanny, be tender with my love. 'Cause it's all that I got, and my love won't forsake me. Be tender with my love. You know how easy it is to break me. Fanny, be tender with my love. 'Cause it's all that I got, and my love won't forsake me. And they fade out. Well, got through it. Voice only broke a couple times. Anybody want to do that one again, or we want to move on and you can play that one at your leisure? Nope, nobody wants to do that one again. Okay, it's a good song. It's a good song. Just play it along with the Bee Gees and it sounds a whole lot better, especially if you turn their volume up and your volume down. No, I'm just kidding. Okay, here's the song I was thinking of, Irene, when I threw it in the set. I said, oh, this will be perfect for her. Lost in Love. Now, I don't know what I got. I got some strange noises coming out of my amp or stuff. Maybe I'm running out of gas on my charge. This was by the group Air Supply, and unlike America, they didn't try and hide the fact they were from Australia this time. But they had some major hits in the 80s. And this one went to number one in the adult contemporary chart for 6 full weeks in a row and number 3 on the overall chart in 1980. So we've got songs here from, you know, the 1930s all the way up to the 1980 and everything in between. Pretty straightforward song. All the chords are 8 counts in this song. All the chords are 8 counts. So you don't have to make any quick changes on this. All of them are pretty straightforward, I think. And the only kind of interesting item on this is on the bridge, when you get to the end of the bridge, where I've got that carry on times two in parentheses, you don't hit that C until the second time we sing carry on. I want to carry on, carry on. So you'll get that. Other than that, pretty straightforward. You know, the outro is when I say echo verse, if you listen to the song, they overlap and layer each other singing. And so we're not going to be able to do that because obviously you guys can't sing back to me. And I couldn't do it this morning because nobody sang in that damn group at all. Ah, but someday we'll bring our singers back. But anyway, here we go. Let's do it. E, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I realize the best part of love is the thinnest slice, and it don't count for much, but I'm not letting go. I believe there's so much to believe in. So lift your eyes if you feel you can. Reach for a star and I'll show you a plan. I figured it out. What I needed was someone to show me. You know you can't fool me. I've been loving you too long. It started so easy. You want to carry on, carry on. Lost in love and I don't know much. Was thinking aloud and fell out of touch. But I'm back on my feet, eager to be what you wanted. So lift your eyes if you feel you can. Reach for a star and I'll show you a plan. I figured it out. What I needed was someone to show me. You know you can't fool me. I've been loving you too long. Started so easy. You wanna carry on, carry on. Lost in love and I don't know much. And I'm thinking aloud, fell out of touch. But I'm back on my feet, eager to be what you wanted.
Instrumental, they're all 8 counts.
Can't fool me. I've been loving you too long. Started so easy. You want to carry on, carry on. I'm lost in love and I don't know much. Was thinking aloud, fell out of touch, but I'm back on my feet, eager to be what you wanted. Lost in love and I don't know much. I was thinking aloud, fell out of touch, but I'm back on my feet, eager to be what you wanted. Now I'm lost, love, lost in love. Lost in love. Now I'm lost in love. Lost in love. Lost in love. Oh, lost in love.
Yeah. Pretty song. You know, they pretty, you know, you can see why it sold a lot of records. And of course they have a lot of the same kind of soft love songs. Roger Hitchcock was the lead singer, and you know, he did all the real high parts and had a real clear voice, and so they were justifiable in their success. The songs are pretty simple though on chords and stuff like that. So I'll probably chart a few more of them. I think I did one of them a while back, but I can't remember which one. Okay, you want to do that one again? We got, or we want to move on? Let's move on. Move on. Okay. All right. It's an easy song, so you shouldn't have any problems trying to keep that one going. Okay. This is a song by Dickie Lee. Dickie Lee, we did a song of his either last year or maybe the year before. He was a big country and Western guy, and he crossed over in the early 60s and started selling a lot of records on the big chart. And this was a follow-up to the song that we did a few years ago. Maybe it was last year, but it was a dead teenager song called Patches. You remember that? There's a three-quarter time song, and it you know, she jumped in the river because he called her Patches, or everybody called her Patches. So anyway, this was his follow-up song to that. And it went to number 14 in 1963. I think I got to go the other route on this one. But this is a nice circular song. So basically all the chords are just right there in the first four. It's the same stuff basically all the way through it. So it's basically ding. Before, just when I thought it was really okay, I saw Linda yesterday. My heart went up, down, like a merry-go-round and round, like a forest fire down, down. Oh, 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 oh. Looked like I found peace of mind. Looked like I was gonna make it this time. Just when I thought I was really okay, I saw Linda yesterday. She smiled that same old smile. My heart was running wild. My love for her increases as I go all the pieces. Hey, hey, dum de do de do de hip, hip, dum de do de do de hip, hip. Dum-dee-dee-dum-dee-dum-dum-dum. Straight to a lonely guy. Sit around and watch me cry. People ask what's wrong, I say. I saw Linda yesterday. My heart went up, down, like a merry-go-round and round. Like a forest fire down, down. Oh, 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 dum-dee-dee-dum-dee-dum. Hip, hip, dum de do de do de hip, hip, dum de do de do de dum diddly dum diddly dum 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 dum. Hey, hey, dum de do de do de hip, hip, dum de do de do de hip, hip, dum de do de do de dum diddly dum diddly dum 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 dum. 2 minute song, good song. Now, this is the first of two Linda songs that I don't know why. When I was a kid, I thought I was going to marry a Linda. Didn't. And actually, you don't find too many Lindas anymore because it's not one of the current cool names. I don't know of anybody that's naming the babies these days Linda, which is kind of strange, but it's a good name. And we got an interesting story about our next song. But let's do this one again. But this is an opportunity when you get to the dum dum dum. It's a good time to be able to use your roll strum. So that's a good. Sorry, my key again. These are keyed to the record, so it's a little straining for me to hit some of these. So I'm going to have to drop down an octave to do it. But here we go.
Dum diddly dum diddly dum 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 straight to a lonely guy. Sit around and watch me cry. People ask what's wrong, I say. I saw Linda yesterday, hopping up, down like a merry-go-round and round, like a forest fire down, down. Oh, dum-diddly, dum-diddly, dum-dum-dum. Hey, hey, dum-diddle-diddle, hip, hip, dum-diddle-diddle, hip, hip, dum-diddle-diddle, dum-diddly, dum-diddly, dum-dum-dum-dum. Hey, hey, dum-diddle-diddle, hip, hip, dum-diddle-diddle, hip, hip, dum-diddle-diddle, dum-diddly, dum-diddly, dum.
So that's your roll strums again. You just kind of keep your finger packed like that and just bring it across the strings. So that's the roll strum. Okay, let's move on to our next Linda song. And this is a great one. This is part of the Great American Songbook. I could have saved this one for another time, but since I said I'm going to do Linda songs, we're going to do this. This was written by a guy named Jack Lawrence. And Jack was quite a prolific writer. He wrote Frank Sinatra's first big hit, All or Nothing at All. And he also did the English lyrics for Beyond the Sea for Bobby Darin. And he wrote this for a good friend of his, who was his lawyer. And he had a brand new baby daughter, and he named her Linda. And the lawyer's name was, I believe it was Roger Eastman. And so it was Linda Eastman. And Linda Eastman grew up to be Linda McCartney. This is the Linda, song was written for the Eastman. She's part of the Eastman Kodak family. And so she was the photographer, and then she ultimately married Paul and was part of Wings before her untimely death. So this was written for Linda McCartney, or who will ultimately become a Linda McCartney. But it was a number one hit in 1946 for Buddy Clark, who was a tremendous singer. You should listen to his vocalization. But, you know, they have the clip on YouTube actually has it as part of one of them. It was tied into a movie as well. But just the basic. Buddy had a great song, and one I haven't charted yet that I've got the 78 for that I play often is You're Breaking My Heart. And it's a great song, and I love Buddy Clark a lot, but he was a big band singer. But this came out in 46, 47, so the big bands were kind of starting to slip a bit. And so at this point, it was fortunate that he was in the movies a little bit as well. Anyway, so this again, Linda McCartney, to you, from Jack. Just vamp on the F.
When I go to sleep, I never count sheep. I count all the charms about Linda. And lately it seems, in all of my dreams, I walk with my arms about Linda. But what good does it do me? For Linda doesn't know I exist. Can't help feeling gloomy. Think of all the love that I've missed. We pass on the street, my heart skips a beat. I say to myself, hello, Linda. If only she'd smile, I'd stop for a while, and then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda mine. Do 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 do. But what good does it do me? For Linda doesn't know I exist. Can't help feeling gloomy. Think of all the love that I have missed. We pass on the street, my heart skips a beat. I say to myself, hello, Linda. If only she'd smile, I'd stop for a while, and then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda mine.
Pretty little song. Pretty little song. Let's do that. You want to do that one again? We got plenty of time. We can do that. Here we go.
When I go to sleep, I never count sheep. I count all the charms about Linda. And lately it seems, in all of my dreams, I walk with my arms about Linda. But what good does it do me? For Linda doesn't know I exist. Can't help feeling gloomy. Think of all the love that I've missed. We pass on the street, my heart skips a beat. I say to myself, hello, Linda. If only she'd smile, I'd stop for a while, and then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda mine. But what good does it do me? For Linda doesn't know I exist. Can't help feeling gloomy. Think of all the love that I've missed. We pass on the street, my heart skips a beat. I say to myself, hello, Linda. If only she'd smile, I'd stop for a while, and then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda mine.
That's a pretty song. Pretty song. Well, let's move on to Born Too Late by the Ponytails. Now, this is a 1958 song, and it was written by a guy named Charles Strauss. And this was back when he was writing singles and stuff like that, but he ultimately turned into a great musical producer or musical writer, Broadway musical writer. And in fact, he is the author of Bye Bye Birdie, you know, among others. So he is quite a prolific writer, but this is kind of a cute song, and it was done by the Ponytails, obviously because of what's behind the title. And it was in 1958, was a number 7 in the U.S., number 5 in the U.K., and so it was a pretty big hit worldwide. Now we have that C sharp minor that's back up in the intro. We're back up to that 4th fret. So, you know, we E. But the nice thing again is your E, when you do your E, you're already got your fingers on the 4th fret. So to locate that, you can feel it. Easy to hit. Easier to hit, let's say. Now we have that G sharp minor fellow that we've been playing with today, and I'm trying to get you to work it into your routine. And that is on second line. Right on the first line over you. Once again, we're that G sharp minor. So we're just look for that one. Other than that, I think it's pretty straightforward. No key change. But here we go.
Born too late for you to notice me and you. I'm just a kid that you won't date. Why was I born too late? Born too late to have a chance to win your love. Oh, why was it my fate to be born too late? I see you walk with another. I wish it could be me. I long to hold you and kiss you, but I know it never can be, for I was born too late for you to care. Now my heart cries because your heart just couldn't wait. Why was I born too late? Born too late for you to care. Now my heart cries because your heart just couldn't wait. Why was I born too late? Why was I born too late? Too late.
I lied. There was a key change there. There was a key change. But easy chord key change because you're going just to the going to F. So that makes it actually easier to play the second part of the song. So cute little song, and you know why this was okay with the BBC, but not the Dr. Hook song. I don't know. I don't get that. Same kind of theme. Here we go. Let's do it one more time. And it's just kind of a lithy, you know. So it's just kind of da, 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 da. Here we go.
Born too late for you to notice me with you. I'm just a kid that you won't date. Why was I born too late? To have a chance to win your love. Oh, why was it my fate to be born too late? I see you walk with another. I wish it could be me. I long to hold you and kiss you, but I know it never can be, for I was born too late for you to care. Now my heart cries because your heart just couldn't wait. Why was I born too late? Born too late for you to care. Now my heart cries because your heart just couldn't wait. Why was I born too late? Why was I born too late? Too late.
Cute little song. Cute little song. All right, let's move on to one that isn't cute. There were a lot of hisses and boos and stuff this morning on this one, because we have not one, not two, not three, not four, not five. Yes, six key changes. So we're not screwing around today on the key change. So I consider this an exercise song on how you move around the fingerboard, playing basically the same melody, but just you're changing the key like about every other verse. So we got six key changes. Now, the reason that this was by the Four Seasons, of course, and it was a number 13 on the Billboard, number 9 on the Cashbox charts in 1966. And the reason they called it the Opus 617 was that this was their 17th single release. So this was the follow-up to Working My Way Back to You, and it came off the same album as that one. But this was their 17th hit. And it tried to make it sound a little like the Toys song that I couldn't, I thought I had it and I lost it again. We did it a couple of years ago that was based on a classical piece. The Toys did it. Anybody got any idea? I don't know. But so they tried to make it sound like a classical song, but it obviously wasn't based on anything other than just what it is. So we got lots and lots of work here on this one, but let's give it a run. So it starts off with a big drum roll, boom, 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 and then it's just basically. Oh, I can see there ain't no room for me. You're only holding now your heart and sympathy. If there's another man and girl, I understand. Go on and take his hand and don't you worry about me. I'll be blue and I'll be crying too. But girl, you know I only want what's best for you. What good is all my pride if our true love has died? Go on and be his bride and don't you worry about me. I'll be strong, I'll try to carry on. Although you know it won't be easy when you're gone. I'll always think of you, the tender love we knew. But somehow I'll get through, so don't you worry about me. Ooh, baby, do-do-do-do, baby blue. Crying too. Before you say goodbye, remember if he ever leaves you high and dry, don't cry alone in vain, don't ever feel ashamed. If you want me again, just don't you worry about me. I love you no matter what you do. I'll spend my whole life waiting if you want me to. And if this is goodbye, you know I'd rather die than let you see you cry. Because you'd worry about me. I'll be strong, I'll try to carry on. Although you know it won't be easy when you're gone. I only think of you, the tender love we knew. But somehow I'll get through, so don't you worry about me. I'll be strong, I'll try to carry on. Although you know it won't be easy when you're gone. I'll always think of you, the tender love we knew. Somehow I'll get through, so don't you worry about me. I'll be strong, I'll try to carry on. Although you know it won't be easy when you're gone. I'll always think of you, the tender love we knew. But somehow I'll get through, so don't you worry about me.
Okay, be honest, did you keep up? It's a challenge. It's a challenge, but you know, they did it. We should be able to do it, but we're going to do this one more time, but it's, you know, you could take this in sections and just work sections of it and then realize that again, you're just moving up, you know, moving up the fingerboard and changing the keys. And this gives you a great opportunity to be able to learn some of your transpositioning. And, you know, find songs that, you know, you like, but I can't sing that. But then you can transpose them and get them into a key that works best for you. And if you can't do that, then you just go to a song like this, which got six keys. And by God, somebody's got to be able to find a key they like in this thing. So anyway, I knew when I charted it, as soon as I put it in the stack, I said to my wife, I says, they're going to hate me. They're just going to hate me for this. But, you know, it's that massive. It's a sadistic part of my personality, not masochistic, sadistic part of my personality to spring this on you. But anyway, here we go. Here we go. Let's do this one more time. Oh, I can see there ain't no room for me. You're only sudden sympathy. If there's another man, then girl, I understand. Go on and take his hand. Don't you worry about me. I'll be blue and I'll be crying too. But girl, you know I only want what's best for you. What good is all my pride if our true love has died? Go on and be his bride, and don't you worry about me. I'll be strong, I'll try to carry on. Although you know it won't be easy when you're gone, I'll always think of you, the tender love we knew. But somehow I'll get through, so don't you worry about me.
Now, the other thing that's good on this song is if you get to playing it, this is also another good one where you practice by reading the chords or keeping here and then letting your hand move here without, instead of doing this. You can't play this song by doing this. So find a section of the song where, like, for example, the third, fourth one down, I'll be strong. You guys can play these chords, G, B minor, C, D, G. And of course, you can play this song all in one key if you wish. I mean, there's no reason that you have to keep changing the key. It's a great song and it's a great melody line. So you just pick one of the keys that you can play. You don't have to play the G flat or the A flat or the E flat, you know, or the D flat. You can play, oh, there's an A, you know, let me play the G side of this thing and play those chords and then extrapolate it. So you can play around. And that's the beauty of music. You can do whatever you want with it. But I charted it so that, again, you can play your Four Seasons records and be right there with them. All right, let's move on to our country and Western song of the day, which is written by a guy named Terry Stafford, who you may remember the song, which I for years thought was Elvis singing it. But the song Suspicion, Suspicion, my heart is breaking, Suspicion. So he wrote that song. Now, Terry was actually a born raised resident of Amarillo. So this is a song that he wrote for himself. He released it in 1973, but it didn't do that well. You know, his one big hit was Suspicion, and it went to number 31 on the country charts. But the guy who really made a big hit out of this was George Strait, and that's what I charted. And that was in 1983. It was a number one song in Canada, a number four song in the United States on the country charts. So the only thing that's odd about this song is that on the top of the top line, when you get to the A at toward the end of the line, that is an eight count. And that's the same thing on the middle of the page where you go down after the instrumental, the second line down, there's an A there. That is also an eight count. And on the top of the second page, because we have, yes, friends, a key change. We have a key change. And we're bringing back that G sharp minor. I told you we're going to work that one today. That B at the end of that top line, that is also an eight count. So they just don't, you know, you'll hear it from me, but don't run too far ahead of me. on it. But this is a great song. Now, when I put something in parentheses, like on the end of the second line, that means that is the D that is in the instrumental line. So that just picks right up where the instrumental begins. So that anytime you see a parentheses like that, that means that's that chord is brings into that because he sings a little over. So here we go. Amarillo by morning, off from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I got on. Hang on the eight. That sun is high in that Texas sky. I'll be bucking at the county fair. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo, I'll be there. Dun-dun-dun-dun, dun-dun-dun-dun. Took my saddle in Houston, broke my leg in Santa Fe. Lost my wife and a girlfriend somewhere along the way. Hold the eight. But I'll be looking for eight when they pull that gate, and I hope that judge ain't blind. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's on my mind. Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I got on. Hold the beat. I ain't got a dime, but what I got is mine. I ain't rich, but Lord, I'm free. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be. Da-da-da-da. Pretty straightforward. Okay, let's do that one again. Here we go. Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I got on. When that sun is high on the Texas sky, I'll be bucking at the county fair. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo, I'll be there. Saddle in Houston, broke my leg in Santa Fe. Lost my wife and a girlfriend somewhere along the way. But I'll be looking for eight when they pull that gate, and I hope that judge ain't blind. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's on my mind. Amarillo by morning, up from San Antonio. Everything that I got is just what I got on.
I ain't got a dime, but what I got is mine. I ain't rich, but Lord, I'm free. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be. Amarillo by morning, Amarillo's where I'll be. Da da da.
Pretty song. All right, let's go on to Isn't She Lovely? It's a jazzy kind of song. And this is written by one of our Michiganders. So this is our Michigan, one of our Michigan-made songs, is our Michigan-made song of the day. And it was not on Motown. It was on a Tamla release. But originally, this song was 6 minutes and 30 seconds long. It's written by, of course, Stevie Wonder. And it is just a joyous song about the birth of his daughter. And it is fantastic. And of course, it's so sad because he couldn't see her, you know, so he's here at the birth of his daughter, but he's obviously blind. But he did this song originally in 6 minutes and 30 seconds. I think it was on his album, Songs in the Key of Life. And he eventually, because it was so popular off of the album, that they decided to recut it to a 3-minute version, which is basically what we have here. So it's got some really cool chord patterns, particularly that C sharp minor 7. So basically you take your index finger and put it across the first two and then bring your pinky to hit the A string. You could use your ring finger, but I like the pinky because the next one is the F sharp. So you slide up. And I like to have my pinky finger there because it's easier for me to find that F sharp by just sort of expand my hand. And then I'm suddenly right where I need to be for that F sharp 7. Okay. Any other funky chords here? I think there's one G sharp 7, which is, we did that one earlier, which again, you can cheat by not hitting the G string. So you go to the A major 7, which is just the first two to the G 7. But I would recommend you bring your, either bar it or bring your index finger over to the G string and play it that way. But very pretty, pretty song. Okay, here we go. And it's a jazzy arrangement, which, and of course, we don't have our harmonica player here, which would be very, very helpful with the song because he has some incredible stuff. And it was beautifully produced record. And he originally did this with a band behind him, and then he threw everything out and just did it himself. He played all the instruments on it. Bass line, everything was on the keyboards, and he added in all the harmonica parts. So he's quite a song all in all. So here we go. I'm gonna do that again. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute old. I never thought through love would be making one lovely as she. Isn't she lovely, made of love? Isn't she pretty? Truly the angel's best. Boy, I'm so happy. We have been heaven blessed. I can't believe what God has done. Through us, he's given life to one. But isn't she lovely, made of love? Oh, do 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 da 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 da
Isn't she lovely? Life and love are the same. Life is Aisha, the meaning of her name. Londi, it could not have been done without you who conceived the one that's so very lovely, made of love.
So you play that skit. He plays it twice. No reason for us to do that. So too fast, too tough. What's the verdict on that one? I mean, it's a jazzy song, but it's a very pretty one. But we can move on. We got one song left. We can do that one again. And anybody want to do that one again? Irene's no. Sally, what do you think? No. Roger, you've been outvoted. Phil, you want to do it again? You and me, we'll just do it. Phil can do it. Anyway, play along with the song on YouTube, and you'll get these chords. And, or again, slow everything down. That song sounds just as good slow, you know. You can play it just. Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious? Less than 1 minute old. I never thought through love would be making one as lovely as she. Isn't she lovely? Just because he hustles it along doesn't mean you have to hustle it along. So it's a pretty song. Pretty song. Okay, let's do Pretty Little Angel Eyes, and we'll wrap her up. This was done by Curtis Lee. Yeah, that's a classic in the doo-wop stuff. In 1961, it went to number 7 on Billboard, number 6 on Cashbox. It was produced by Phil Spector. And it was written by Curtis Lee and Tommy Boyce. And I don't know if you guys remember Boyce and Hart, but they did a bunch of great songs in the 60s, and they wrote a bunch of stuff for the Monkees. So they were quite prolific in their own right. But this was one of his early ventures. Now, the slash marks are basically, you know, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty, pretty little. So that's what the slash marks are. Now there's a tiny pause at the end on verse number 1. When your darling angel eyes, there's a pause, and then it goes pretty, pretty, pretty little angel eyes. So there's that. And I think the rest of it's pretty straightforward. We don't have any key changes on this one. So, but anyway, let's try. Give her a run. Pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little angel. I want to slow that down. I don't want you to go that fast. Let's do this a little slower. Pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little, pretty little, pretty little angel. Ooh, pretty, pretty, pretty little angel eyes, angel eyes. I really love you so, angel eyes, I'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Pretty, pretty little angel eyes, angel eyes, you are so good to me, in your arms, you are so heavenly, you know I love you, my darling angel eyes.
sent from heaven above. You fill my life with your wonderful love. And I'll be happy for eternity, 'cause I know, whoa, 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 that our love is really real. Angel eyes, I really love you so. Angel eyes, you'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little, pretty little, pretty little angel. Do 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 do. Angel eyes, I really love you so. Angel eyes, I'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Pretty little angel eyes.
That we can slow it down a little bit further. Anybody want to do that one again? Or everybody done? You want to do that one again? Okay, Sally, we'll do it again. We'll play it slow again. I mean, it's a pretty fast song in the on the record, but let's do it again that pace, maybe even a little slower.
Pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little, pretty little, pretty little angel. Ooh. Angel eyes, I really love you so. Angel eyes, I'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Pretty, pretty, pretty little angel eyes. Angel eyes, you are so good to me, and when I'm in your arms, you are so heavenly. You know I love you, my darling angel eyes. Angel eyes, I know sent from heaven above. You fill my life with your wonderful love. I know we're happy for eternity, 'cause I know, whoa, 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 our love is really real. Angel eyes, I really love you so. Angel eyes, I'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Angel eyes, angel eyes, pretty little angel eyes, pretty little angel, pretty little angel, pretty little, pretty little, pretty little angel. Do 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 do. Angel eyes, I really love you so. Angel eyes, I'll never let you go, because I love you, my darling angel eyes. Pretty, pretty, pretty little angel eyes.
I know I pushed you and punished you, and but I hope you had a good time. And, you know, again, some of those songs, just play them slow. Just slow them down, break them down, work the sections that you haven't played before or having troubles with, and just see what you can do about, you know, bringing those sections together, and then just piece them all at a slower pace, and then eventually pick them up. So we had a bunch of pretty easy songs, a lot of four chord like this one, which is just revolving, you know, those same four chords on many of them today. So hopefully you had some fun. And, you know, I promise not to bring out six chord change songs often, once in a while, just to tease you. But again, pick a section of that song out and just play the whole thing the same way. You don't have to change the key just because they did. And thank you so much for joining, and hope you have a good time. We will look forward to, thank you. We will look forward to getting together again in November. That will be my last meeting. I don't know if I'm going to be going to California or not, but we're going to turn the thing back over to Ben if he's feeling good, and he can start the winter session. And I'm sure he will not be punishing like some of these songs. So I may have to pull out one more, you know, stab you in the eye song or two for the next meeting, but we'll try and keep it easy and fun.
Well, that is great, Dave. Really good song.
Thank you.
Good time.
Thank you. And thanks to Ryan, our moderator, for doing this. I mean, the poor guy does double duty. And I feel bad about killing his whole day because he's got two beautiful daughters, and he probably, his wife's wanting to, you know, hey, spend time with them. They love you too. But we love him. And thank you for having us and handling this for us. So terrific. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, thank you.
See you next month. I can figure out how to leave. I don't know. Oh, there it is. Bye now.
So long.